Welcome back. Now, this is a subject that I find very interesting because it is literally a part of almost everybody's modern day life, usually in silence. Many of us have seen circuit breakers in our house or business, more than likely because a circuit breaker tripped. Circuit breakers are safety devices that interrupt the flow of current to a circuit if there's either a gradual increase in load or a short circuit, which trips the breaker instantly. Most common times for a breaker to trip are when cooking, or for most girls, when blow drying their hair. I've even heard some girls say that they're scared to use a hair dryer because it trips the breaker and they think it's gonna cause a fire. But the whole purpose of having a circuit breaker is to prevent a fire from happening in the first place. So we know they trip, but what happens inside the circuit breaker when it trips is what I'm trying to figure out. So in this episode, I'm going to replicate two types of faults. The first one is gonna be a slow blow or an overload. And the second one is gonna be a complete short circuit. My idea behind this is to show people how the circuit breaker works in a way that everybody can understand. Inside the circuit breaker, we find a couple of key components: the actuator mechanism, contacts, the terminals where we make the wire connections, thermal magnetic strip, and last but not least, the lever that we use to turn a circuit breaker on or off or reset it in case it trips. All right, ready to go. I'm just gonna straighten this out a little bit and I'm gonna be careful because that is now live. Okay, let's go. We now have too many appliances running on one outlet, which has created a situation where the current draw of the appliances exceeds the amperage rating of the circuit breaker. This overcurrent condition heats up the bimetallic element, changing its shape to the point where it releases the lever, trips the circuit breaker, and interrupts our circuit. Let's watch that again. Well, that was really interesting. Our breaker just came apart somehow. Instinctively, I don't feel safe touching all this, but I double checked and that's unplugged. What I'm gonna do now, I'm just gonna try to put this back together. So, looks like this spring is actually what holds these components together. And this spring has to be like a 5-pound spring. Man, it's hurting my finger just to put it in place. Heard that click? That has a lot of tension. All right, this is gonna be our last slow blow before our short circuit. Brenda, hit it.
I'm doing it now.
All right, so that looked pretty good. As you can see, our breaker is now tripped, and that's what it looks like when a circuit breaker trips. So I'm gonna reset this breaker here. Let's take a look and see what it looks like when you reset it. To reset a trip breaker, a lot of people get confused with this. You first have to turn it off. You can see what the levers do inside, and then turn it on. And now our circuit is closed and we're ready for our next take. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to replicate a short circuit, a complete short circuit. I know it's gonna seem crazy, but I'm gonna do it really simple. I'm just gonna get two wires and touch them together, which is gonna be a realistic replication of a short circuit and see what the breaker does. First thing I'm gonna do is get my welding mask and my gloves for safety. Oh yeah, baby. Our dollar store extension cord. We're gonna unplug our appliances and plug in our extension cord. All right, here we go. Short circuit condition. In 3, 2, 1. Now, in a short circuit condition, this breaker does something pretty amazing. There's so much current passing through that strip, it creates a strong magnetic field that pulls that lever open almost instantly. I found it mind-boggling how fast this actually happens. And if we look at the image data, we can see that the entire event took a mere 6 milliseconds. After watching the overload and the short circuit scenarios, the one thing I noticed is that this particular breaker, which is the most common household type, seems to be thermomagnetic. What that means is they've combined two mechanisms in one, a thermal overload for gradual overcurrent situations and a magnetic device in situations that need to be interrupted immediately. Oh, I just almost touched that. Short circuit number two. Here it goes. Well, there you go. Hopefully I warped your perception on circuit breakers. Next time you have a circuit breaker trip, now you know what's happening inside. And that's about it. That's how a circuit breaker works. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. And don't forget to leave any opinions or suggestions in the comments section below. You could hold all the complaints. Until next time, hasta mais.